How do I look? I look nice. Hi, I'm Sheila Steffens, and welcome to A House of Prayer. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord.
Hello, my name is Cynthia Martinez, and I am the founder and president of Words of Comfort, Hope, and Promise, a military outreach dedicated to support our troops and their families. And we're very excited here. My friends and I, we were invited to receive recipients of the Governor's Award here at the Double Tree Suites in Anaheim, California. And as you can see, we're holding up a banner. We received these awards simply because, not because we deserve it. Our troops deserve it. We love our troops and their families, and we support them. And that's why we're holding up this banner today. We want to let everybody know that we love our troops, we support them, and we want to invite everybody to come alongside us to help support them also. Many of my friends here, Pastor Roger Bayless and Jenny, his wife, are from Christian Mission Church in Laguna Niguel, very supportive of what I do for the ministry, and also our wonderful Connie behind me, and wonderful cook, by the way. And then we have Millie, wonderful in supporting what we do with gift baskets, Ron and Irene. They've been with me since we started our ministry. I have back here Marilyn from Christian Mission Church also, and my assistant, Nancy Ramirez, behind me, who is also my sister-in-law. But we're here today, again, because we would like to honor our troops. We would like to thank them for serving our country and to let you know that you're not alone. You have not been forgotten. I know the war has been a long time, but we have not forgotten you. We're gearing up to sending care packages to Afghanistan, one MEF forward, and we're honored to serve our troops. So God bless you from Anaheim, California. Let's throw a kiss. Mwah. We love you, our troops.
Love you.
God bless you, and may God bless America. God bless America.
Cynthia Martinez, president and founder of Words of Comfort.
Hello, my name is Cynthia Martinez, and I'm the president and founder of Words of Comfort, Hope, and Promise, a military outreach dedicated to support our troops and their families. I would like to send a message to all of you and our servicemen and women who serve our great country. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. I love you all. I appreciate you. I'm at home. I support you through our prayers, care packages, and support, and I just want you to know that you're America's best. You're our heroes. We love you and appreciate you so much. And we look forward to you coming home. God bless you.
What exactly do you do for the troops? Can you tell me in detail?
Yes, I live close to Camp Pendleton, and we support the troops out of Camp Pendleton. Also, we've supported the Marines out of 29 Palms, and what we do is we support a battalion during the deployment. And when we support that deployment, our military and their, we also support their families. With, for example, we recently, in April of last year, we had Marines from 1 MEF, 1st Marine Expeditionary Forces, that deployed for a year to Afghanistan under Major General Mills. He's over 31,000 Marine and sailors. And we wanted to send our support out to them and also their families. Right after they deployed in the following month, we had a luncheon for their spouses. We know the sacrifices that their military wives are making. Separated from their husbands a year is a long time, and they're being father and mother at the same time. And the sacrifices they're making, and I wanted them to know, we understand, we support you during your husband's deployment. And this is a time when they come together, they bond, they exchange phone numbers, and they're the support team. They support each other during the deployment. That means a lot to me.
How does the community react? How does the community actually support
both the troops and their wives. How is that working?
What we do is we want to make an awareness of who we are, our organization. We reach out to the community, to churches, family and friends. We let them know what each project or event that we're planning, and we ask them if they would like to support our efforts. And we recently sent care packages out to Afghanistan for Christmas, and we sent around 2,000 Christmas stockings. And baked home-baked cookies from the Girl Scouts from Irvine came out, and they made thousands and thousands of cookies that we were able to ship out to Afghanistan. I would like to introduce two very, very good friends of mine, Pastor Roger and Jenny Bayless. They have been so supportive of our military. As a matter of fact, they have two grandsons, one serving the Army and one just graduated out of boot camp from Camp Pendleton. He's a Marine. Thank you for coming out today. Wasn't it wonderful today?
Yes. Wonderful day.
Wasn't it wonderful?
Incredible.
We're here.
Wow.
Well, we're here today. Why are we here today, Pastor Roger? Do you want to share with everybody why we're here today?
Well, thanks to you and Words of Comfort, Hope, and Promise, we're here today to receive awards for the efforts that we've had through Words of Comfort, Hope, and Promise to support the troops that are in the field, and to give them, as much support as we can through snacks, through socks, through blankets, through you name it, we've sent it, and we've sent just shipment after shipment to the troops that are out in the field, and so we're being recognized today for those efforts, and it's all through really thanks to you and Words of Comfort, mm-hmm. Hope, and Promise.
Well, you know, I am so honored when I received the phone call that we were going to be receiving the Governor Schwarzenegger and Maria Shriver's award. We were out doing Christmas shopping, for our troops when I received the phone call, and I was just shocked. Mm-hmm. I mean, I didn't even know there was such an award. And when Anna indicated to me, what about any of your volunteers? I said, oh my gosh, I have so many wonderful volunteers that mm-hmm. all came out today, and there were 37 altogether as recipients. Wow. You know what? To me, that was the greatest joy for me, because you have all been there, your labor of love, and I really feel that God is honoring you mm-hmm. because you've honored our servicemen and women that are defending our great freedoms. And so I really feel that this was God's way to say thank you for your labor of love, and all the others that came out today to show their support to our troops. So thank you. I know, Jenny, we've had a lot of fun coordinating beach parties, and I know that the troops love the brats.
Yes,
they love
they
those
do.
brats. And what
he's the brat man.
And so we want to give back. We want to let them know we love you. Thank you for your service to our country. And how did you enjoy yourself at the Christmas party that we were so honored to be able to attend today?
All the events are a blessing, but to me the Christmas party is the most, because you get to see all the children.
Yeah.
And how happy they are when they get all their gifts and toys, and just they're so grateful. And I feel more grateful and honored to be able to do that for them, and I wish we could even do more. And we do more, but it's just never enough.
Yes.
Because they're so wonderful. They're, like you say, our heroes.
They are.
And they just need to be shown that appreciation, to me, 24/7. But
absolutely. And, you know, this year we were able to support 7 Christmas parties at Camp Pendleton. Mm-hmm. And we had more fun getting those toys and separating them for the girls and the boys, and watching their big eyes open up when they receive their toys. I remember when I was little, that was my favorite holiday. Mm-hmm. And so it was an honor to be there with them. This year we celebrated with one MHG, which is one MEF, and their families. It was a wonderful, lots of Marines and their families. And so, again, thank you for all your support.
Thank you.
And I know we're already starting to work on our Valentine's care packages coming up. Words cannot express how grateful I am to you, Pastor Roger and Jenny,
Thank you.
All your support to our troops.
Thank you.
A lot of people may not understand that the troops don't really have very much. And whatever little we can do is very appreciated. You may be wondering why Why do we throw beach parties? Why do we throw Christmas parties? It's because they really don't really have much. And when you see the children receiving the gifts and the Marines coming home from Afghanistan, which is just the most desolate place, and they're greeted with a gauntlet of people thanking them and shouting, and you see the tears running down some of their eyes, and these big Marines, you know, really get touched in their heart because they've given all, and it's just so little really for us to give back, but it's really appreciated. As much as people can do to take away some of that loneliness that they feel is worth just a lot to these people. And so we don't, you know, we received an award today, but I don't really feel like we've given as much because they've given all.
That's
and
right.
They're willing to give their lives.
That's
to
right.
Protect our freedoms. And
yes,
so,
yes.
You know, I'm thankful for the award, but they are our heroes.
Absolutely. I agree with you. We don't do this for awards. We do it because we love our troops and we appreciate them. Mm. And so thank you so much for, we brought a van full of people here today from our church to receive those awards. And I just love you both so much.
Can
thank
I
you.
Just
yes,
one little thing?
Absolutely.
One little thing. With you were there when Michael graduated.
Yes.
I mean, he was there. And he opened the bag and he was like, he received gold when he saw the socks.
Tell him who Michael is.
Michael's my grandson who just graduated from boot camp at Camp Pendleton. But Cynthia was so kind to give him a big duffel bag with all the goodies that we send out. And here's this bag of socks. And when he opened, he goes, socks! Socks! These are like gold! And we go, I know. We send them out all the time. He goes, you don't understand. These are like gold. So he was so blessed that you gave him that. He was like, you don't know because you left the room, but he was so blessed with the socks.
Oh,
I mean, that goes to show you they have so little.
Yeah. Well, you know what? We got to do more. And that's what, you know, I appreciate being on this program so that we can share what we're doing and how other people can help our efforts so we could support as many of our troops and their families that we can. So thank you.
Thank you
so much for coming today. Thank you. God bless
you.
Love
you.
Well, what type of items are in your support care packages?
For example, we're gearing up right now for Valentine's Day. We're going to be shipping out care packages on January the 29th. It's cold in Afghanistan right now, very cold. We're going to be sending warm items like hand warmers, beanies, socks, also scarves. It's very cold, and they love Starbucks coffee, and a lot of the customers from Starbucks have donated coffee, and also we're going to be sending soup, cup of noodles, tea,
okay,
a lot of items that our troops will appreciate,
okay,
during this cold season.
So how can other organizations and individuals help?
Absolutely, yes.
So what do they need to do? How can someone actually step forward and say, I want to do my part? What can they do?
They can contact me on my website. They can email me, and or they can call me, and I'll be happy to give them information and add them to our email list, and we'll keep them updated in regards to our upcoming projects and events. I would like to introduce my wonderful friends, Ron and Irene Lord, from La Habra Heights. Thank you for coming out today, and congratulations for receiving the Governor's Award for
Thank
your
you.
Support of our troops and their families. I appreciate you both so much. You have been with me from the beginning. We started way back in 2004, and I remember you started out making hundreds and hundreds of cookies. For our troops,
yeah.
The best chocolate chip cookies. I remember that, and you've just you've been here when we first started. And why don't you tell me what supporting the troops means to you, Irene?
Oh my gosh, it has been such an honor to serve the military and their families, and seeing the love, you know, being poured out to them because they deserve all that we can give them. I mean, and I just. It's been just an honor. There's just no words to describe how awesome it is to serve them. And you know, the cookies. I mean, that's just a way of saying, you know, we love you and we appreciate you guys so much. You know, they're just, you know, they're our heroes.
That's right.
Yes,
they're our heroes.
I can't even begin to tell you how much of a blessing it has been to be part of this ministry and to see the fruits of the ministry in the smiles of the children, the smiles of the troops, the calm-heartedness of the wives that I know that we help to inspire just by letting them know that we support them. And it's such a blessing, and it's so fulfilling, and I could do this for the rest of my days and be happy.
Or any other statements that you'd like to present?
Yes, I would. Sheila, I received this letter recently after sending the care packages to Afghanistan. And again, the American people need to know the great work that our troops are doing out there in Afghanistan. They need to know that they're making a difference, and they need their support. And this is a letter that I received, and again, this means more to me than anything. This came from Afghanistan, and I'm just going to read a short paragraph. Please rest assured that our troops, along with our coalition forces, partner nations, are making great and positive strides over here. The quality of life of the Afghan people has been significantly improved by the roads, bridges, water wells, schools and courthouses, and local markets that are being constructed for the most part by local national contractors. The government services are responding to the needs of the local people, and the Afghan National Security Forces have excelled under the training programs we have in place and are increasing their abilities to protect themselves, the people of the government of Afghanistan, from terrorist threats. This is a very rewarding time to be here, and I look forward to seeing even greater accomplishments in 2011. Isn't that wonderful?
Fantastic.
Yes.
I know that God is, He is great. Would you mind giving a prayer for 2011 and a prayer for our troops?
Absolutely. I'd be honored to. Dear God in heaven, I come before you in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I lift up our beloved troops to you. Father, I ask for divine protection over them to keep them safe from all attacks of the enemy. I pray, Father, your promises over them. You said that you keep them from all evil and preserve their lives, that you satisfy them with long lives and give them your salvation. Lord, I ask that you protect them from danger. I ask that you warn them of any attacks from the insurgents, the Taliban. Father, I ask that you help them to overcome their enemies, and that, Lord, that you will continue to give them health and strength, Lord. Give them peace, Father. And Lord, I pray above all, Lord, that you would just reveal your mighty love for them, because they are our heroes. And Father, I ask this in Jesus' name. And Lord, bless their families. Comfort them during this time they're away from their loved ones. Just give them peace. Provide their every need, Father. Give our military leaders wisdom and discernment, Lord God. Warn them of attacks of guerrilla warfare, any ambushes, of IEDs, Father. I ask, Lord, that you hover over them with your mighty angels. And Father, I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
I'm Marilyn Mulligan, and as a mother of four sons who never had to go to war, I have a great heart for the young men and women that are fighting to serve and keep our country free and to help bring liberty to those who don't know the joy of freedom. Thank you for all you do. God bless you. Know that you're in our prayers, and we can't wait till you get home. Thank
you. And God bless our America.
Talk about America. Why should God bless America? I think you just did a historical study.
Yes.
Yes. With David.
David Barton. He's a historian. And, I mean, he knows about our history more than anyone I've ever heard. And we have a rich history. America was birthed during a great awakening. America has a destiny and a purpose to be a beacon light on a hill. And many nations have been blessed through our country. Americans are the most giving people I've ever met in my life. They are the greatest people. I have the greatest team, Sheila, and I just, you know, we're here today. You're interviewing me here today because we just received the award, the governor's award, Governor Schwarzenegger and Marie Shriver's award, and I just thank God for every single one of our volunteers, because it's because of them and all of those that have helped our efforts is the reason why I received this award. And going back to America, I love my country. And again, we are a beacon light on a hill. And we are the free world. we have freedom. This is the way God created all man to live, to have freedom. I was born and raised here. I don't know anything else but that. And I give all that honor to our military, our troops. Because of them, we have this great America and the freedom that we have. And so, yes, I am learning much about our wonderful history. And I thank God for the privilege of being born here in America.
I thank him also. And I say, God bless America from sea to shiny sea. And I thank him for crowning America with brotherhood. I just love America. I love being a patriot. I love the Lord. I love that this country, this nation,
yes,
was dedicated to him.
Yes.
And since we're dedicated to the Lord, I don't think he's going to open his hands and let us go. This is a sovereign nation unto the unto our Lord Jesus, unto
yes.
God. And America is a nation unto God.
Yes, it
and
is.
I'm going to define God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Yes. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
King of Kings, Lord of Lords.
Lord of Lords, absolutely,
and
Sheila.
Jesus Christ is God who came down from the heavens to walk with us. He came down to walk with us to give us the good news that he has made us in right standing with the Father. All we have to do is believe in our hearts and trust him, and God Almighty will protect us and keep us safe.
Absolutely. And you know, Sheila, again, he inspired me. He called me to serve our military because of the love he has for our troops. And we, you know, our Constitution, our Declaration of Independence, many of they took scriptures, our founding fathers, when they framed America, they took scriptures out of the Bible. They seek God's wisdom. And this is the reason why we have the most prosperous nation in the world. And because God is, with the Spirit of the Lord, there's liberty. He wants liberty for all human beings. He loves, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son. And so, I love my country. I thank God for America. And I know that God is going to help our troops in this war against terrorism. So thank you.
Hi, my name is Manch Mansky. I just wanted to say to all the men and women that are serving, thank you. And a special note to my brother-in-law, John Savage. Please come home safe. We miss you.
Hi, my name is John Mansky. I just want to tell everybody thank you for fighting for my freedom. Come home safe. Thank you very much.
We are honored to be here today at the wonderful, in Anaheim, California, participating in the Governor's Award ceremony, and it's such a pleasure to meet you. We have Miss California Mercedes Harvey here to give a welcome and a warm greeting to our beloved troops.
Hi.
What'd you like to say to our troops?
Well, first off, I just wanted to say thank you so much for everything you've done in our country. I believe it or not that you have a lot of people here that back you up. I can't even imagine the things that you go through over there. I see about it on the news, but I know a lot of it's covered up, and reading the newspaper and just seeing what's on TV isn't quite enough. I would love to come visit you sometime. It would be incredible. But I just wanted to say thank you so much. And in this new year, I hope that you guys are safe. Let you know that God loves you, and he is so thankful that you are here to serve our country. I am proud to be an American with you serving our country and knowing that you are there to back our freedom up, to help people in that country that need your help. But I can't go over there, but you can, and you can do things that I can't, and you are my hero.
Yes.
And I just wanted to say thank you so much for everything you've done for us and for those people over there, and that, you know, when you come home safely, you are heroes in this country.
Yes.
Thank you
right.
so much.
Yes. Thank you so
You're
much.
Very welcome.
Thank you so
it's
much.
An
honor. God bless. Thank
God
you.
God bless.
Hi, I'm Dolly Chacon, and I'm on the Board of Directors of Words of Comfort, Hope, and Promise. And we just want to thank our troops. We love you so much, and we are so grateful. You are on the front lines to help protect this nation from all harm and danger. And we just do a shout out to you of love. We love you, we thank you, and we bless you.
We are working on, it's called Adopt a School. And this is in Helmand Province. And a Major DeAnato is she is the one who is coordinating and working this out. We want to support her efforts.
It's called the Adopt-A-School Project. And why this program is great is it allows the American public to contribute not only to the Afghans, but to the Marine Corps in ways that help us curb violence. And when we curb violence, that means less Marines lose their lives and less Marines are injured. So that's huge for us, and there's really no other way Americans can contribute to that end. So what this means is American service organizations, charitable groups, private entities, they are given a designated school in Helmand Province. And it's a specific school with a specific name, and maybe it's 8 through 6, and maybe it's 8 through 12, and we let them know all this information. And what that group does is they put together two mailings of classroom supplies, which really support these schools. They have no other way to get classroom supplies, because there's no money for that here. So the group shifts over two deliveries full of classroom supplies, and in the end of the classroom supplies is the same thing you'd see in an American classroom. There's rulers, paper notebooks, colored pencil packs, erasers, protractors, glue, art paper, all the things that make school great is exactly what we're asking these groups to do. And people have stepped up. Of the 24 schools, we have 50% of them adopted, and we have the spring window coming up, which is during April. So we're really trying to reach out and get all these schools adopted so they can end with a bang and just still continue their progress, because they've made huge gains here in the year we've been here. Just to give you an example, at the end of last year, there was only 104 schools open. Now there's 115 schools open, which doesn't seem like a lot, but I'll tell you, in 2005, there were no schools open in Helmand Province. So it's massive gains year by year.
He said he told me how much the children love the backpacks, how much they want to learn. And he said that every time they saw this particular general and the sergeant major, they would say, "Do you have pencils for us? Do you have papers?" He said they want to learn, and here they are with their bare feet.
Hi, my name is Deborah Record Gomez, and I am a proud American here to thank your families. Thank you for the foundation that enables you to go home, and they're here taking care of business at home. So we're trying to help them and keep them safe and keep them focused. So we thank you, and my daughter wears Army boots, and oorah to the Marines. Yeehaw!
Hi, my name is Mel Thompson, and I really want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for serving our country. We love you, and we pray for you, and we can hardly wait till you get home. Keep up the good job. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Jamilis Chamblu. I go by Millie. We just want to tell you we love you. Take care, and we're waiting for you guys to come back safe and happy for all of us. God bless you, and we'll be praying for you. Dios te bendiga.
Hi, my name is Carol Fee. I'm from San Juan Capistrano, close to Camp Pendleton. And I've been serving you guys for several years with wonderful events that we show you our appreciation and love for you. And we just want to give you that love through the airwaves, that we are praying for you, we love you, and we just, God bless you all. And thanks for everything you do for us Americans. Amen.
Hi, my name is Dan Ramirez, a Vietnam veteran, and I just want to say to all you brave men in uniform, God bless you. I thank you for your service to this country, that's still the greatest country in the world, and blessings to you all. We love you all, and our prayers are definitely with you all. God bless.
Hi, my name is Oyuki Ramirez. I'm so blessed being able to send you our love and our blessings to all of you, because we are so proud of you, and we pray for strength for all of you, and we pray that you will feel blessed to be there and fighting for our country, that our country is the best country in the world, and it always be the greatest country. We love you. We want to let you know that our prayers are upon you day and night. God bless you, and we love you.
Welcome, and thank you.
Thank you, Sheila. Thank you so much for coming out and filming this wonderful event.